You are listening to In the Moment on SDPB. I'm Lori Walsh, and we are broadcasting live today from the Washington Pavilion in Sioux Falls. We're inside the Schulte Room, and we have a live audience as people are arriving for the South Dakota Arts Conference. They're getting registered for a weekend of conversation and advocacy, and we've got a little table here in the corner, and Amy Phil has had a seat, because upstairs if you're familiar with South Dakota art, you know this person. You're probably familiar with the work of Oscar Howe. And upstairs right now, there is a beautiful exhibit that deals with his legacy and a lot of the artists who have been inspired by Oscar Howe. He was a cultural icon who innovated and defined the modern Indian art movement. The exhibit is called Oscar Howe, Legacy Across Four Generations. And this weekend, there is going to be a panel discussion here talking about the art of Oscar Howe. The exhibit is co-curated by Amy Phil and Keith Braveheart, and Amy is the University Art Galleries Director at the University of South Dakota. She's also an installation artist and founder of the Rural Cloud Museum, which is a mobile art studio. And I'm just getting to know her and her work, and I am delighted to have her here on In the Moment. Amy, welcome. Thank you so much for being here.
Yeah, it's great to be here. Thank you for having me.
Keith Braveheart has been a very generous artist to come up and talk with us on this show a number of times. He's such a great ambassador for all things art in South Dakota. Mm-hmm. And you are doing that work alongside of him, and I'm excited to have you here as well. Tell me a little bit about this particular exhibit and thinking about Oscar Howe and how he has influenced all these artists today.
Yeah, working with Keith is like always really wonderful. He has great ideas, and he's very passionate about Oscar Howe's legacy and the impact he has had on so many artists that have maybe worked with him as younger students or as young emerging artists here in our state and across the country.
Yeah. Tell me a little bit about your work at USD. And we've been talking with everybody here about being a kid with Play-Doh or a theater kid or a kid making poetry when she's 10 years old. What's your arts journey? Tell me how you got your start as an artist.
Yeah, I think I started as a photographer and with my degree in art history. And I moved forward and started playing with painting. Yeah. Dealing with, more of an expressive way of working. And then I took some time off and did a lot of art fairs, making glass jewelry, lamp working. And later in my life, I realized that I wanted to go back and get my master's degree. So I received that in 2017 and as a sculptor. And this has been really a great way for me to take everything that I really enjoy, experimental art, playing with improv, spontaneity and playfulness. And I really enjoy creating environments and spaces that create some sort of joy or experience.
The art education, getting that advanced education, that was a huge leap to make the commitment to study deeply like that. When we look at people like yourself and Keith Braveheart and Oscar Howe and other people who really dove deep into the history of art, what is it as an academic pursuit that changes you as a maker?
I think just kind of working in the context of art and art history, what's come before and what's happening now. There's so many avenues we can take now and materials and ideas and concepts. So those are the things that really kind of challenge me and I'm curious about.
Yeah. Tell me a little bit about the Oscar Howe Legacy exhibit, some of the artists that participated in it and the very interesting things they brought to the table.
Yeah, we had, across four generations. So Keith kind of took the lead on that, and his idea was to divide into the four generations following Oscar Howe, and then to round it out to the number 16, which is kind of an important number So we had four artists per generation. So we had artists who have worked directly with Oscar Howe, and then younger artists, emerging artists who are more experimental, so doing more installation and video work, being inspired by Oscar's paintings, like Autumn Cavender. She referred to the Hyde painting. The artists were asked to like kind of maybe reflect on one of Oscar's paintings. So she recreated the space that we see in that two-dimensional plane of the painting and brought it into the three dimensions, yeah, and included video. Talon, Basile Dachenot, he really explored Howe's legacy and stepped into the South Dakota Oral History Center at USD, mm-hmm, and referred to Oscar's interviews and some of the things he talked about, so incorporated that into his work. Mm. Which is also very exciting.
And if you don't know, if you're listening and you don't know who that is, I mean, you got to check out Talon Basile's music. And so when you go up there, there's just like a record player and a radio and audio things you can touch, mm-hmm, and start the music yourself and participate in and hear Oscar Howe's voice mixed in this whole new, really exciting way. It's one of my favorite pieces in the exhibition is that, because of course I love audio and sound and,
yeah,
and him. Which brings me to this question of moving art forward. And mm-hmm, at USD, you're thinking about the strong artistic traditions and the Oscar Howe Summer Arts Institute, mm-hmm, and the gallery spaces that you have. And then the new students are coming in and the new people are thinking about all of this in new ways, which is what Oscar Howe did. He redefined that for America. Tell me a little bit about arts education at USD and some of the things that you're seeing through your work as a curator with young artists coming and changing the game.
Yeah, I think, there is, all artists generally have like a connection to some history and art. I feel like there's a lot of young artists are embracing community-based art, okay, and more collaborative arts. I think using new media, you know, we see with Talon.
Yeah.
Just being really exploring their own identities and how that, how to communicate that as well.
Yeah. I was up at the South Dakota Art Museum last weekend for the opening of Navigating Narratives there, and I was walking around looking at the paintings, and there you were. You had a piece in that. Tell me a little bit about that piece that you made for, and this is, if you don't know, a re-examination of Lewis and Clark when they come through this territory, looking at their journals, what's missing in those journals. Dr. Craig Howe has done all this scholarship, mm-hmm, to help the artists and poets and musicians participate in a new retelling of this time. Tell me about your piece in that.
Mine was a collage using magazines and different advertisements, and was really speaking about the land, mm-hmm, and what has been done to the land, and maybe questioning how, I guess, speaking of colonizers and those who discovered America.
Yeah. And air quotes she's making, yeah, her hands for the radio listeners discovered.
So
yeah,
kind of challenging that idea of doing what's right, you know, with industrial farming and ideas like that. Nothing, we need all of these things, but also my work spoke about, you know, being a little bit more careful with how we move forward and how we're using our land, our water, our systems, yeah, you know, food scarcity.
It was a perfect example when I was standing in front of that about just what we're talking about here is artists speaking to the moment that we're in with something that maybe we all think we can do as children, which is collage, you know, who mm-hmm hasn't played with that? And then elevating that medium to this really innovative level. So I enjoyed that piece.
Thanks. Yeah, it was great to kind of resource what is out there, you know, the mass, the materials, world culture, and how to make a story using those types of items.
All right. Oscar Howe Legacy Across Four Generations, Artist Reception today, Friday, June 7th, 5 to 8 p.m. at the Pavilion. We're going to put links up to all of this on our website. That is our show for today. Amy, Phil, thank you so much for being here. To the wonderful audience, thank you for being here and helping us make some live radio today from all of us at SDPB. Live from the Arts Conference in Sioux Falls, we thank you for listening.